described and captioned media program. In the classroom and on the go. DCMP.org.
Mazzarelli Media presents Student Health and Safety, Stopping Bullying Through the IEP.
There is a small but growing amount of research that has shown that students with learning or physical disabilities are at greater risk of being bullied. There are several reasons for this. One reason, it is often much more difficult for a child with special needs to recognize behaviors that are socially appropriate or inappropriate.
Different scenes are shown of boys arguing.
Even typical children struggle with peer acceptance and finding where they fit in a group.
A girl makes a crying gesture to another.
Disabled children and teens face an even greater challenge.
A girl holds eyeglasses out of reach.
On the other side, a child's disability feeds into the bully's sense of power and control in being mean, and may come to the conclusion that this child doesn't have the ability to do anything about it. So, what can the IEP team, teachers, administrators, specialists, and parents do to protect a child? This program will present ideas that work to bring about positive outcomes.
Next to a photo of a boy resting his head on his fist. Title:
Identifying Bullying Behavior. What is bullying behavior? You think it would be a simple answer, but it's not. That's because bullying behavior is open to interpretation by the observer. What is perceived as bullying behavior for one person may not be for another. Legally, it's open to interpretation as well, depending on your state or district.
Joanne Friedberg.
Bullying is a very, very difficult concept to define.
Education consultant.
Approximately 44, 46 states, and the number grows. We're reaching 100% of states have some kind of anti-bullying legislation. And each one of them defines bullying in slightly different ways. Bullying is a concept where if you look at it in terms of the wide range of what people generally believe about bullying, at its base is about abuse of power. And there are disagreements whether that could be one time or it has to be some kind of pattern. But bullying really is about power abuses.
Julie Swanson.
Identifying bullying behavior in schools is a difficult thing to do because it can be so subtle.
Special education advocate.
Bullying generally doesn't happen in front of adult eyes. It generally happens when adult eyes are not looking. And kids are pretty savvy about doing that, okay? You know you're going to get in trouble if you are mean to someone else. So you tend to do that when adult eyes aren't watching.
The Described and Captioned Media Program provides services designed to benefit students who are blind, visually impaired, deaf, hard of hearing, and deafblind. These services include a library of free loan described and captioned educational media, a clearinghouse of information related to educational media access, a gateway to internet resources related to accessibility, and a set of guidelines for adding descriptions and captions to media. There are no user registration or service fees. Visit the DCMP at dcmp.org. The DCMP is funded by the U.S. Department of Education and administered by the National Association of the Deaf.